Welcome to part 5 of the Centrify for Office 365 how-to video series. These videos are intended to guide admins through the preparation of the Office 365 tenant and Active Directory setup and configuration of Centrify for Office 365. Part 5. In this video, we will show the best practices for preparing your Active Directory environment to allow users to authenticate into a federated Office 365 environment with their designated credentials. We also show how to verify that everything has been set up correctly before going live into production. In Active Directory environments, most users are already used to the idea of signing into their accounts with either their username or user principal name, otherwise known as the UPN. Office 365 takes this convention and allows users to log in with the UPN of the Office 365 account as well. The UPN looks like an email address, and in environments where Office 365 is federated for single sign-on, it is actually strongly recommended by both Microsoft and Centrify to have the UPN match the user's email address. These two attributes in turn also need to match the registered domain that was added to Office 365 in the previous video. Once the suffixes of the AD UPN and the AD email address match the Office 365 domain, this suffix needs to be registered in the Centrify Cloud Manager as a login suffix. When the suffix lines up in Active Directory, Office 365 and Centrify, we are good to go for single sign-on into Office 365. It is important to ensure that each user who will be synced into Office 365 has a valid and unique value for their UPN. Any duplicate UPN values in the environment will cause a sync error and will not be accepted by Office 365. If the user's primary UPN suffix does not match the Office 365 domain, then there's no need to fear. You just need to add it as an alternative UPN suffix so that it is still recognized as part of the user's corporate identity and that it still lines up with the Office 365 and Centrify suffixes. UPNs that are used for single sign-on can contain letters, numbers, periods, dashes, and underscores, but no other types of characters. Remember, Office 365 domains must be rootable on the internet. Domains such as .local or .internal cannot and should not be used with the UPN attribute for single sign-on. If you are planning to sync your AD users into Office 365 using Centrify Provisioning, the following user and group object attributes should be validated prior to enabling Centrify Live Provisioning Mode. The attributes are display name, mail, proxy addresses, SAM account name, and user principal name. Preview mode should always be used for testing. This validation step will help ensure accurate user account information is being synchronized into Office 365. Most of the attributes will likely be populated already, but there may be inconsistencies if Microsoft Exchange has been installed in the AD environment. Objects such as groups created in Exchange will have different attributes populated when compared to groups created using ADUC. If objects are missing certain attributes, they may get filtered and will not synchronize as expected. In the same way that login usernames are created using the UPN attribute, the default email address and email aliasing for a user comes from the proxy addresses attribute. Note that this means the email address does not come from the mail attribute. It is an understandable confusion, but it is still important to have both attributes be present and populated along with the others for successful syncing to occur. It is recommended to also enable the Enable Hybrid Exchange Support option within the Centrify for Office 365 app provisioning settings, regardless of whether hybrid exchange configuration is actually in use. If this setting is not enabled, only a limited set of user object attributes will be provisioned into Office 365, and full account attributes and group objects will not be synced in. Successful single sign-on and directory synchronization between on-prem Active Directory and Office 365 requires that your directory attributes are properly prepared and aligned. Validating these attributes prior to deployments can save time, effort, and prevent unwanted frustration for admins and end users. For additional information, product registration, and support, please visit us at www.centrify.com.